بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear brothers and sisters, in the last episode, we talked about some of the states of the people on the Day of Judgment, as well as an introduction to the Day of Judgment. And today, inshallah ta'ala, is a very important episode. And this is on the subject of some of the things that people will go through on the Day of Resurrection, on the Day of Judgment, which we mentioned previously that many people deny. But on that day, they will come to regret it. So we will list a few of the things that people will experience on the Day of Judgment, and we ask Allah to protect us from the evils of that day. The first thing that we need to remember is that when the people are brought out of their graves, when they're brought out of their graves, they're remembering the things that they did in the life, the things that they did in the previous world. And they also will remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us about this day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about this day, and it's not like any other day. It's a mighty, severe day. أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنَّهُم مَّبْعُوثُونَ لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. So do these people not think that they will be resurrected? لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ, for a mighty day, a severe day. Now why is it severe? Because of the questioning that will take place. يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. On that day, all of mankind will stand before Allah, Lord of the worlds and everything that exists. The second thing is that the eyes of the people will be staring. They won't be blinking. And the hearts will be beating against their throats. The hearts will be beating against the throats. The people will wish for their hearts to either come out, to go back into their proper places. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the example of this. وَأَنذِرُهُمْ يَوْمَ الْآزِفَةِ إِذِ الْقُلُوبُ لَدَى الْحَنَاجِرِ كَاظِمِينَ. So warn them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on a day that is drawing near, when the hearts will be choking the throats. And on that day, the people will be standing there in fear, waiting to meet Allah, waiting to meet the Creator for everything that they've done in the past, to be questioned. Finally, the day that everything built up for. Now, as they're waiting in fear, as they're waiting in fear and chaos and terror, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the description of the people with their families and companions. Because on the day that you come to meet Allah, when you're running around looking for good deeds and for people to take your sins, to take your burden off of you, you won't find anyone to help you. Furthermore, we know that the people of evil, they will be ready to give up everything on that day. Imagine for a moment that someone is in danger and you ask them to give up something huge, something big to them. They would give it up to protect themselves. So on that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the description of these people. وَلَوْ أَنَّ لِكُلِّ نَفْسٍ ظَلَمَتْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ لَفْتَدَتْ بِهِ. If every single person, everyone who had wronged themselves by disbelieving in this world, disbelieving in this land, and by committing wrongdoing and evil, if they possessed everything on this earth of wealth, they would not be able to use that wealth to ransom themselves from the hellfire. Meaning they cannot pay to get their way out of the hellfire. Furthermore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَمَاتُوا وَهُمْ كُفَّارُ فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمْ مِلْءُ الْأَرْضِ ذَهَبًا وَلَوْ افْتَدَى بِهِ. Those who disbelieve and those who died as disbelievers, it would not be accepted from them the entire earth full of gold if they tried to use it to ransom themselves. And on that day, they will have no one to help them. No one to help them. So they cannot ransom themselves out of the hellfire. They cannot pay their way out of the hellfire. And they are doomed to face the consequences of their sins. And we ask Allah to protect us from these traps of shaitan. We also have a beautiful narration where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us, and it is reported by Bukhari. He says, the disbeliever will be brought forth on the Day of Judgment, and it will be said to him, do you think that if you had an earth full of wealth or gold, that you would be able to ransom yourself with it? The man will say, yes. So do you think you'll be able to ransom yourself with an entire earth full of gold? He will say, yes. And then it will be said to him, I used to ask you for much less than that. And truly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us to worship Him and to fulfill the basic rights of the Creator upon the creation. So these people, they're not being asked to give up the entire earth full of gold. They're not being asked to do anything unreasonable. Everything in our faith, everything in Islam is reasonable. And everything is in our benefit, whether we realize it or not. The salah is in our benefit as human beings. The prohibitions are beneficial for us as human beings and as individuals and as societies. So they preserve society. Everything that we have is for our benefit, and it is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All we have to do is accept the gift and ask Allah to make us of those who are steadfast in believing in Him and to make us of those who are steadfast on the Day of Judgment. Now, another of the terrors of the Day of Judgment, another of the problems and chaos that people will endure on that day, and we ask Allah to protect us from this, is the fact that the Day of Judgment is 50,000 years. خَمْسِينَ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ فَاصْبِرْ صَبْرًا جَمِيلًا. So the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, فَاصْبِرْ صَبْرًا جَمِيلًا. So be patient, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a lengthy and complete patience. إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا. They see the Day of Judgment as something far away. They don't think it's real. They think it's something far and distant. وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. But we know and we see it as close, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that the Day of Judgment is close. And so we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us on the standing of that day for 50,000 years. We can all think of people we know in our lives, or maybe ourselves. We cannot stand in line and wait for anything. We are impatient. And you can see that in a person's character, impatience. So can you imagine someone standing for one day, or for 1 week, or for 1 month, or 1 year, or 50,000 years? Can you imagine standing for 50,000 years? Furthermore, the standing itself is not just standing. You're standing there sweating, and the people are sweating according to their sins. And the worst part is, they know where they will end up. They're anticipating what will happen. A similar example that we might go through in this life is when a person knows that they are failing an exam, or they're not really sure of the results of their exam. So they're waiting for the results. They're waiting to see the grade. And they say that the time of waiting, the entire time of waiting, is terrible. That feeling alone is horrible. It's misery. And so these people are standing for 50,000 years. Another example of this is the people who in some countries are on death row. So they're going to be killed according to the death penalty. Now these people, when they're interviewed, they say that the time from when they knew their punishment was coming, their death was coming, until the day they die, that time in between was the worst thing ever. Meaning the killing itself wasn't the worst thing they were anticipating. It was the waiting. It was the waiting. So the anticipation on the Day of Judgment is at a severe high for 50,000 years. Furthermore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He describes it, He says that these people, when they look back at this life, what are they going to say? وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةُ يُخْصِمُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ مَا لَبِثُوا غَيْرَ سَاعَةً. On that day, when the hour comes, when the Day of Judgment comes, the mujrimun, the evil people, they will say, we were only in the previous life for an hour. سَاعَة. In another ayah, it was referred to, كَأَنَّهُمْ يَوْمَ يَرَوْنَهَا لَمْ يَلْبَثُوا إِلَّا عَشِيَّةً أَوْ ضُحَاهَا. It's as if we lived in this life for a part of a morning, or a part of a noon or evening. Can you imagine for a moment giving up an eternity of Jannah for an hour of this life, an hour of doing whatever you prefer, whatever you desire, uncontrolled desire? Can you imagine giving up an eternity for a few days in this world? Is it worth it? Only an insane person would give up paradise for this life. Only an insane person would give up an eternity of paradise and happiness for an hour of luxury and desire in this world. And truly the believer, when they capture their nafs, when they capture themselves, they begin to discipline themselves so that they can control their nafs and the nafs will not control them. And this is what Islam seeks to give us. And that is why the acts of worship, including as-siyam, it is for our self-discipline. So that on the Day of Judgment, because of the discipline we had in this world, when we're standing there on the Day of Judgment, we're standing there in happiness and we're standing there in peace. We're going to take a short break, inshallah ta'ala, and we'll get back to some of the terrors that people will go through on the Day of Judgment. Stick around, inshallah ta'ala. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Before the break, we were discussing some of the terrors that people will experience on the Day of Resurrection. Some of the terrors that they will go through, some of the chaos and the anticipation and the fear. And we mentioned the length of the Day of Judgment as 50,000 years. Another of the terrors of the Day of Judgment, another of the trials of the Day of Judgment, is the heat of the sun on that day. So the Prophet ﷺ tells us that on the Day of Resurrection, The sun will be brought close to the people, that it will be as close to them as 1 mile, meal. And this is reported by Muslim. And the people will be sweating according to their sins. The Prophet ﷺ tells us in authentic hadith that some people, their sins will cause them to sweat up to their ankles, others up to their knees, and for others it will come up to their shoulders, and for some it will come up to their necks, and for others it will cover their mouths, and some will be drowning in their sweat because of their sins. And we seek refuge in Allah from enduring that on the Day of Judgment. Furthermore, of the trials of the Day of Judgment is the argumentation, the dispute between the kafir and the devil companion, between the kafir and the qareen. And every one of us has a companion. Every one of us has a qareen, a devil with us. And we seek refuge in Allah from these devils and their whisperings and their traps. So on the Day of Judgment, a person will be arguing with their qareen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Qaf, وَقَالَ قَرِينُهُ هَذَا مَا لَدَيَّ عَتِيدٌ. And man's companion will say on the Day of Judgment, this record is with me prepared. The record of what this person has done is prepared. Some scholars interpret this as the angel that was recording. أَلْقِيَا فِي جَهَنَّمَ كُلَّ كَفَّارٍ عَنِيدٍ. It will be said, throw him into the hellfire, every obstinate or stubborn disbeliever. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes these people. مَنَّعٍ لِلْخَيْرِ مُعْتَدٍ مُرِيبٍ. These people are preventers of good. They prevent the doing of good, and they are aggressors with their arrogance, and they are doubters in the Day of Judgment. الَّذِي جَعَلَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرٍ فَأَلْقِيَاهُ فِي الْعَذَابِ الشَّدِيدِ. The ones who made equal with Allah partners. So let these people be punished into the severe punishment. And we also know that as they continue and argue, they will try to blame their qareen. They will try to blame the devil. So what does the qareen say?
قَالَ قَرِينُهُ رَبَّنَا مَا أَطْغَيْتُهُ وَلَكِنْ كَانَ فِي ضَلَالٍ بَعِيدٍ.
The devil will say, O Allah, our Lord, I did not make him transgress. I did not make him commit sins, but he himself was in extreme error. He chose to make these sins. He had the free will. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respond?
قَالَ لَا تَخْتَصِمُوا لَدَيَّ وَقَدْ قَدَّمْتُ إِلَيْكُمْ بِالْوَعِيدِ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, do not dispute before me. Do not argue before me. Why I had already presented to you the warning of the Day of Judgment. This is the Day of Al-Wa'id.
مَا يُبَدَّلُ الْقَوْلُ لَدَيَّ وَمَا أَنَا بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ.
The word will not be changed with me, and I will not be unjust or unfair to any of the servants. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day will tell those who are blaming their qareen, those who are blaming the devils, that I warned you about this day, and I warned you about the qareen, and I warned you about the traps, and I warned you about the illusions, and you have the answers in front of you. It's an open book exam. All you have to do is study and take what you have, take what Allah presented to you. Another thing that will happen on the Day of Judgment to these people of evil is the argumentation that will take place between the evil people and their limbs. Their own bodies will argue with them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that these people will argue when He says,
حَتَّى إِذَا مَا جَاءُوهَا شَهِدَ عَلَيْهِمْ سَمْعُهُمْ وَأَبْصَارُهُمْ وَجُلُودُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ.
So on that day when they're brought to it, when they're brought to the hellfire, شَهِدَ عَلَيْهِمْ سَمْعُهُمْ, their hearing will bear witness against them. And their bodies and their sight and their skin will bear witness against them for what they used to do. بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ.
وَقَالُوا لِجُلُودِهِمْ لِمَ شَهِدْتُمْ عَلَيْنَا.
So now the people will argue with their bodies, their skins. Why are you bear witnessing against us? Why are you bear witnessing against what we used to do? Meaning you're also going to get punished with us. The body will be punished. So the person is arguing and the body is responding.
قَالُوا أَنطَقَنَا اللَّهُ الَّذِي أَنطَقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ خَلَقَكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ.
So the bodies will respond and they will say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that gave us the ability, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that created us the first time, created the soul and the body the first time, and to Him you shall return. So the disbelievers will try to argue, and they will try to lie, and they will claim that the messengers didn't come to them with messages, and they will blame their qareens. They will be in full denial. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah will place a seal over their mouths, and their hands and their feet will speak of what they used to do. So their mouths are sealed, but their hands and their feet and their skins, they will speak about what this person used to do. So then they will say to their own body and their own limbs, away with you, meaning what are you doing? It was for your sake that I was arguing. It was for your sake that I was arguing so that the body is not punished, so that there is no punishment or consequence. So the person is lying and denying, and this person is claiming that they didn't receive a message or a messenger, or that they did not know the true message, or that the qareen, the devil companion, took them astray. So they will blame and blame and blame. But ultimately, it is up to you, and you have no one to blame but yourself. And this hadith was reported by Muslim. Furthermore, on the Day of Judgment, as you're standing there, you will see people arguing not just with their bodies, but you will see the body argue with the soul. The body will argue with the soul. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah reported that Ibn Abbas radiallahu anha said that people will dispute on the Day of Judgment to such an extent that the soul will dispute with the body. So the soul will say to the body, you did such and such. So now the soul is blaming the body. And the body will say to the soul, you told me to do such and such. You inspired me to do such and such. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send an angel to mediate between them, to judge between them. And the angel will say, you are like a paralyzed man and a blind man in a garden. And the disabled man, he tells the blind man, he tells him, I can see some fruit over there, so I cannot reach it. And the blind man says to him, climb on top of me and you can get the fruit. Climb on top of me to reach the fruit. So the angel says, so he climbs on top and they both commit the sin. So who committed the sin? Who is the committer of the sin? So the body and the soul, when they hear the angel ask this question, they will both say, both of these people, both men, are to blame. They both committed the sin together. They helped each other. So the angels will say, you have passed judgment against yourself. You have passed witness and judgment amongst yourselves. In other words, the body is a vehicle for the soul, and the soul is a passenger, and both are crucial, and both are important. Now this is some of what the disbelievers and those who are evil will go through on the Day of Resurrection. But then we have some of the examples of what happens to the believers on the Day of Judgment. Not the pure believers who always repented, but the sinning believers. So there are three categories that we will mention, inshallah. The one that we just covered is the category of those who are evil, and that's their state on the Day of Judgment. Now we will cover the category of those who are sinners, but they were also believers. So the first thing, the first punishment that we should mention is those who did not pay the zakah. Those who did not pay the zakah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us, whoever is given wealth by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and does not pay the zakah on it, his wealth will appear to him on the Day of Judgment as a bald snake, as a huge bald snake with two black spots over its eyes. And it will seize that person on the Day of Judgment and will say, I am your wealth, I am your treasure. And this is the zakah that they did not pay in this dunya. So the zakah, even for the one who believes in Allah, if it's not paid, it will come back to haunt him on the Day of Judgment. The second type of sinning believer that will be punished on the Day of Judgment is the arrogant believer, those who are arrogant. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us examples of this, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam does as well when he said, the arrogant will be gathered like small ants in the form of men on the Day of Judgment, overwhelmed by humiliation on all sides. Furthermore, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the most insignificant or worst name before Allah on the Day of Judgment will be that of a man who was called the King of all kings. The King of all kings, Malik al-Muluk. So this person wants to be called the King of all kings, the ruler of all rulers. So Imam Muslim, he added in one narration that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there is no king except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this was reported by Bukhari and Muslim. Furthermore, there are sins for which Allah will not speak or praise or talk to a person about. So Allah will not speak to certain people or look at certain people or praise certain people on the Day of Judgment because of the things that they did. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there are three types of people whom Allah will not look at on the Day of Judgment. The first is the one who disobeys his parents. The one who disobeys his parents. The second is the woman who imitates men, effeminate men and effeminate women. So these people are trying to imitate each other, and this is a sign of the Day of Judgment. And the third is the dayuth, the man who has no protective jealousy over his woman. What does this mean? So this is the type of man that is not protective of his wife or his own daughters or his sisters or his mother. meaning he doesn't mind people to stare at them, to talk to them, to be open, or to do something haram with them. So these people, they're considered dayyuth, and Allah will not look at these people on the day of resurrection. And this was reported by Muslim Ahmad, and you can find it Sahih al-Jami'. Furthermore, those who will be tortured on the day of judgment are those who betrayed others. Those who betrayed others, Allah will expose them on the day of judgment. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, on the day of judgment, for every betrayer, a banner will be raised according to the extent of his betrayal, and no betrayal is greater than that of a ruler over his people. And this was reported by Muslim. So the greatest betrayal is the one who has power to make things good for those who are beneath him, and so they make these things more difficult, such as a ruler, for example. And we have many of these trials in our day and age when many of the rulers are betraying their own people, especially in the Muslim Ummah, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from their harm. Furthermore, of the others that will be punished, inshallah ta'ala, and we'll finish up with this last category, is the one who seizes land by force and the one who is two-faced. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about the one who seizes the land by force, whoever seizes any portion of land unlawfully, meaning you took something that was not yours, will be swallowed up by it on the day of judgment and will sink to the seventh earth. And this was reported by Bukhari. As for the one who is two-faced, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you will find the most evil of people on the day of judgment, the one who is two-faced, who presents one face to one group of people and another face to another group of people. And this was reported by Bukhari. And the scary thing about this hadith is that many people, they show one face with certain Muslims or with certain elders or with certain cultures, and they'll go to another place in another group and they'll show a completely different side of themselves, a terrible side of themselves. So this person has some issue in their belief, some issue in their heart, where they're not the same person everywhere they go. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our intentions and to make us of those who are not two-faced. And the last one is the ruler who stays distracted or indifferent from his people. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that this type of ruler who is indifferent from the needs of his people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be indifferent and distant from this person on the day of resurrection. And this is sahih, reported by Abu Dawud. This is the end of our episode for today, inshallah ta'ala. And we will continue next time, inshallah ta'ala, by finishing up the last few categories of the sinning believers. And then we will talk about the state of the righteous believers, the hisab between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the hisab that will take place for those who are righteous on the day of judgment, and the things that they will be protected from on the day of judgment. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who benefit from what we hear, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to elevate our ranks in paradise. And this is the end of our episode. Jazakumullahu khairan wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Praise be to my Lord.